You spoke about some of the players there, the Mullen family, the Mullen brothers and cousins in particular. Mark Marino. It's not that you need that extra motivation when it comes to an FFA Cup clash, Robbie. He's 23 years old and he used to play for the opposition tonight in Melbourne City.
Well, for me, this sort of researching Mark Marino and looking at it, and, you know, I still call him somewhat of a kid, although he's not a kid, but he's still a young player. It's a big game for him to show what exactly maybe has been lost to the Hyundai A-League. He had two goes at Hyundai A-League clubs. Adelaide, he played six games. And two assists in that, nine games for Melbourne City, scored a couple of goals. And for me, he is one of the lost generation that I've talked about many times, Boz.
Countless
one of the young players. This is a player that's basically had little game time over his young life. He was a member of the under-20s Australian team. So that's what his talent, you know, that's what it showed that he had. But somehow along the way, because of the disgraceful way the youth has been run in this country for over a decade now, and it's going to take a long time to fix, but this is a stark example of one of those lost generation.
And how many of them there must be?
Oh, there's so many. And
you know, we're highlighting one. There must be hundreds.
There is, of course, there is, because you've got an NYL that plays eight games. Well, if you get to the grand final, you play 10. It's just not good enough, and it's a question that the new guy in charge, Rob Sherman, has now a big task. He's investigating the whole thing, but it's too late for guys like. Well, it's not too late for Mark Marino. He can still make it.
He's
it's a big
chance. He's putting himself in the shop window right now.
He's already
now,
been in the shop window. That's what. Yeah, he was good enough to make the Australian under-20s. He was good enough to be at Melbourne City, good enough to beat Adelaide United. But unfortunately, because we don't have enough clubs, the amount of foreigners, that this kid missed out on his chance at that time, and he's not on his own.
The biggest reason, Rob, is because of the mismanagement of the youth setup for the last 11 100%. Years. It's quite evident and it's quite obvious. I just watched on Fox our greatest team ever, the Socceroos, qualifying in that magnificent game against Uruguay in 2005. And I'm looking at all them players. How were they produced? Where were they brought up? You know, so the new board have got a lot of challenges. This is one of their biggest challenges
because
the youth set up for the last 11 years has been a disgrace, like Robbie said.
Yep.